Braille Fighter.
So, Braille Fighter is another group. They belong to another group of a plant kingdom. And the study of Braille Fighter is called bryology.
Bryology.
So this aspect has to deal with the characteristics of plants, or the characteristics of bryophytes.
The characteristics of bryophytes. We are also going to talk about the classification of bryophytes, the life cycle of bryophytes, as well as the economic importance.
So when we talk about bryophytes, we are going to start from the characteristics. That is the basics. Characteristics of bryophytes. Our bryophytes are common seed plants. They are seedless plants. So the number one characteristic of bryophytes is that they belong to cryptogams. Cryptogams. This simply means that they are seedless plants. They are simple plants. In fact, they are the first plants that can live out of water. They are the first land plants. So this means that they are seedless plants. Cryptogams means seedless plants. So they are a group of seedless plants that are under lower plants. Another characteristic of this thallophyte is that some are thallus, while in other ones, the body is differentiated into rhizoid, stem-like structure, and also a leaf-like structure. So we have some body thallus, and some are differentiated into, you know, rhizoid, stem-like structure, and also a root-like structure. In some books, see that stems or root, but it's not root. They don't have a true root. They lack true root. Stems and leaves. They don't have anything like that. But they are plants, but they don't have true root stems. So what they only have, what they have is that their body consists of rhizoid, stem-like structure as well as leaf-like structure. So they also exhibit what we call alternation of generation. So under their alternation of generation, their gametophyte generation is dominant. We're going to understand alternation of generation later. Then we said that they exhibit alternation of generation, and the alternation of generation, their gametophyte generation is dominant, while the sporophytes depend on it. That is the uniqueness of their own alternation of generation. The gametophyte is dominant, while the sporophyte depends on it. So this group of plants are found in moist or shady environments. They are found in moist, in shady, or damp environment. That is where they can be found. And this group of plants called bryophytes, they don't have vascular tissue. They lack vascular tissue, or absence of vascular tissue. Vascular tissue is absent. So they don't have vascular tissue. They don't have primary tissue as well. So this group of plants also carry out both sexual and asexual reproduction. But before that, they possess a structure called rhizoid for attachment and anchorage. So the gametophyte is anchored to the surface by what we call rhizoid. Rhizoid for anchorage, and this rhizoid also provide nutrition. It absorbs nutrients that this plant depend on for anchorage or attachment. We also said that they carry out both sexual and asexual reproduction is present. So they can carry out sexual reproduction by fusion of gametes.
Sexual reproduction by fusion of gametes is by fission of gametes, while the asexual reproduction occur by spore formation or fragmentation. So when you talk about this group of plants, they are able to carry out both sexual and asexual reproduction. And we said that their asexual reproduction is by, you know, fission of the male and the female gamete, while the asexual reproduction can occur by spore formation or fragmentation, depending on the species. Then we also have examples of bryophytes. The bryophytes are more advanced, thinking of that, they are more advanced than the thallophytes, and they are less advanced than the thallidophytes. So examples of bryophytes are the moss, funaria, you know, Rhysia, you know, Pelia, you know, Mercantia, and etc. Those are examples of bryophytes. So I believe with these few characteristics, you have understand what bryophyte is. Now we are moving to what is regards to as alternation of generation. Out of the characteristics, we mentioned alternation of generation, that they exhibit alternation of generation. So what is alternation of generation? So when you talk about alternation of generation, simply means the phenomenon whereby plants exhibit two distinct phases in their life cycle. It is a, you know, occurrence of two different generations, two different stages, two different phases in the life cycle of plant, and these phases alternate with each other for the life cycle to be completed. So these phases, we say that, you know, occurrence of two distinct phases or stages in the life cycle of a plant, and these stages are the gametophytic generation and the sporophytic generation. The second stage is the sporophytic generation. So plants have the ability to carry out two different stages. A typical example, if you want to understand this better, let's take a look at egg and chicken. So egg transformed to chicken transformed to egg, just like tadpoles and toad. Egg is not the same thing as chicken, but one transformed to the other. So that is how the life cycle is being completed. So when we talk about the gametophyte, it's a stage of the life cycle. Sporophyte is another stage of their life cycle. So what are the features of the gametophyte? What are the features of the sporophyte? So this gametophyte usually carry out a sexual reproduction by production of gametes, and it's haploid. Gametophytes carry out sexual reproduction. All right, gametophytes are also produce gametes. Gametophyte produce gametes, and gametophyte is usually haploid. In fact, because gametes are haploid. That's why the gametophyte produce haploid. But when we talk about the sporophyte, on the other hand, the sporophyte usually, you know, exhibit asexual reproduction. Why the gametophyte exhibit sexual reproduction? Sporophyte exhibit asexual reproduction, and this sporophyte usually produces spores. They produce spores, and these spores are diploid. So that is the differences between the sporophyte and the gametophyte. Why the gametophyte produce gametes? Sporophyte produce spores. The gametophyte carry out sexual reproduction. Sporophyte carry out asexual reproduction. Why the gametophyte is haploid, the sporophyte is diploid. So when you talk about the general life cycle, the alternation of generation in bryophyte is very simple. So we said that these two phases, you know, alternate with each other. So let's say this is our sporophyte, gametophyte. Let's say, because the dominant generation in bryophyte is the gametophyte. So let's say the life cycle starts from the gametophyte. So in alternation of generation, the gametophyte has the ability to produce gametes, both the male gametes and the female gametes.
and a female gamete. So these gametes will now fuse together and carry out fertilization. This fertilization or fusion of gametes. So when fertilization occurs, there will be formation of zygote. Okay, so this gamete is N. Don't forget, this one is also N. The gamete produces, this is the sexual phase where it produces gametes. And this gamete is N. So when the gametes come together, you have two N, which is the sporophyte. So this one will give us to the sporophyte, which is 2N now. So the sporophyte will now carry out meiosis to form spore mother cell, still 2N. So meiosis, it takes place to form spores, and this will give rise to the gametophyte. So that is how the life cycle. This is our alternation of generation. So we have the spores and we have the fertilization. So the sporophyte, the gametophyte. So this is the, you know, sexual reproduction. That is the life cycle. When we have the sporophyte and the gametophyte. So when we get here, we see that the exchange from fusion of gamete, there will be conversion of, you know, haploid to diploid, because the gamete fuse together to form a zygote. So this is the alternation of generation. This is how the life cycle looks like. So we have the gametophytic phase and we have the sporophytic phase. So that is alternation of generation in bryophytes. General. So that is what we mean by alternation of generation in bryophytes. Now we are moving to the classification of bryophytes. So basically, bryophytes is classified into three main groups. So when we talk about classification of bryophytes, and I say that classification, that is classified. Bryophyte is classified into three main groups. We have class Hepatice 1, 2. We have class Mosses, or what we call Bryocida, and we have class Anthocerus, the hump. So let's talk about this characteristic. We are going to talk about the characteristics of these groups because they are different from each other. So let's keep the class Hepatice. So the class Hepatice are simply called Hepatice. This name was derived from a Latin name meaning liver. Liver. So when you hear the liverwort, these are the groups that are called liverwort. So the liverwort are the Hepatice. So Hepatice literally means liver. So they are called liverwort. So this group of bryophyte called Hepatice has some specific characteristics that are different from other group. One of these characteristics is that they produce a thallus. Their body is usually thallus. Body is thallus, or sometimes folius. Their body is thallus, and sometimes it is folius. And sometimes they can be prostrate. Their body occur when they are on the, you know, floor. They are prostrate sometimes, or lobed. Some can be lobed. So this group of bryophyte have rhizoid, yes, but their rhizoid is usually unicellular. The rhizoid is unicellular, and also they also have elaters. We call it elaters. But before then, they are, you know, their gametophyte. We said that their gametophyte is the one that bears the sex organ. The gametophyte bears the sex organ. Or the sex organ are on the gametophyte tissue. gametophyte tissue. And we said that they don't have elaters, presence of elaters, but unicellular elaters. And that elaters helps them to carry out dispersal. They help them to carry out dispersal. Then we also said that they don't have a columella. They don't also have perianth. Absence of perianth, and also, so these are the characteristics of the hepatocyte. They are very common, you know, prostrate or low bryophyte. So examples of the hepatocyte, the liverwort, they are liverwort generally. So we have the Pellia radiosa, we have the Macanthia, those are examples. Macanthia, we have Ehrlichia, those are examples of hepatocyte. So now we are moving to the second group called Moses, class Moses. Now, when we talk about the Moses are usually found, you know, around our environment. They are look like a green grass or green rock on the wall. You know those plants that look like green rock on old walls. They are Moses. So when we talk about this Moses, the whole body is typically the gametophyte. The main body is the gametophyte. You know, the body is the gametophyte. And this gametophyte usually emerge from the young gametophyte. So the mature gametophyte is the whole body. But this mature gametophyte, the younger stage, the juvenile stage of this gametophyte is called protonema. And this juvenile stage of this gametophyte looks like, you know, a filamentous structure, branch structure is green, and filamentous branch structure called protonema. So they have protonema, and that protonema is the young gametophyte. Okay, so this guy, their own gametophyte, he is leafy and is erect. Their gametophyte is leafy and is erect, and you know, leafy gametophyte. When we say leaf is leafy, that means it possesses some structures that looks like leaf. And also they have rhizoid. This gametophyte consists of rhizoid, it consists of stem-like structure. It also consists of leafy structure or leaf-like structure. That is the structure of the gametophyte. So when you talk about the rhizoid is usually multicellular, unlike here where the rhizoid is unicellular. So the rhizoid is multicellular. Okay, so when we also go forward, we talk about the rhizoid, we talk about the leafy, we also talk about the stem. So in their own part, their sex organ are located on the main stem. Located on the main stem. And also, we also have another characteristics like the sporophyte. Now, when we talk about their own sporophyte, their sporophyte are also dependent on the gametophyte. But the sporophyte consists of a foot, a setter, and a capsule. So the sporophyte consists of foot, setter, and capsule. So they have capsule which bears the spores. And don't forget, the rhizoid are spirally arranged, okay? And also, we also have another characteristics of this group that are called Moses. Another characteristics is that they don't have elaters. Where we have elaters are present here, but here we don't have elaters. Okay, I didn't even put it. Absence of elaters. Or do I say present of elaters? Okay, present of elaters here, but here there's absence of elaters. So instead of them to have elaters, they have peristonium. Peristonium is used, presence of peristonium for dispersal of, spores. Presence of peristone for dispersal. They also have, their bodies cover the capsule, they bear spores inside the sporangium. Okay, Then we said those are the characteristics. Those are the characteristics of Moses, and we also have examples. Examples of Moses include Funaria, Polytrichum, etc. Those are the examples of Hygrometrica. Those are the examples of peristome. Also, okay, we have talked about peristome. We said that spores also germinate. The spores also germinate. Peristome. So let's talk about the characteristics of Anthoceracida. So we have the last group, that is class Anthoceracida. So we said Anthoceracida is the last group of bryophytes, and this group their body is flat. In fact, they have dorsoventrally flat structure. Dorsoventrally flat structure. That is the way their structure is, and all the cells in the body looks alike. All the cells are alike. All the cells are alike. So the body is not differentiated internally. No internal differentiation. No internal differentiation of the body. No internal differentiation of the body. That is why we said their cells are alike. The sporophyte is differentiated into the foot, the intermediate zone, as well as the capsule. They also have sporophyte. They have sporophyte, they have gametophyte. And we said that their sporophyte has divided, and their gametophyte is not differentiated. But the sporophyte is divided into foot, intermediate zone, and capsule. Sporophyte, consists of foot, intermediate zone. So they have intermediate ground, intermediate zone, and a capsule. So they have intermediate ground. Those are the characteristics. So each cell has a chloroplast, and the chloroplast has pyrenoid. Unlike this, they have pyrenoid. Chloroplast have pyrenoid. The chloroplast have pyrenoid. Unlike the other group. So those are the characteristics. Those are the characteristics. The capsule also mature from the apex to the base. When we talk about this group, the capsule mature from apex to the base. Capsule, they have capsule, but it mature from apex to the base. So those are the characteristics. And the last example is Anthoceros. Anthoceros. So these groups are called the hornworts. Hornworts. So we have the liverwort, we have the moses, and we have these are the trumos. Trumos. The liverwort, the trumos, and the hornwort. So these are the main group, or these are the classification of bryophytes.